there was only a few guys that were really making some good money at it. And Stacy being one of them. I mean, Stacy, you know, he was making some good money.
I started bringing home these checks, and my parents were looking at this going, what's going on here? Where's this money coming from?
Stacy was the most commercially successful skateboarder in the world. More of his model Warp Tail skateboards were sold, I think, than any skateboard ever produced.
Stacy, you know, handled himself a little bit more mature than we did. I got to give him, you know, credit for that because he represented himself a little bit more professionally than we did, I think, at that time.
He toured the world a lot.
I mean, every time you call Stacy's house, oh, he's, you know, somewhere, Australia, England, Germany, Japan.
I wanted to go out and show the world skateboarding.
What is that?
It's a skateboard. What does it look like?
A skateboard.
Pretty far out, huh?
I grew up in Santa Monica. A lot of drugs ran to the beach that I surfed at, and I saw a lot of guys that I knew were gonna stay on the beach for the rest of their lives. And I wanted to get something out of this. This was my ticket. Finally, I was good at something in my life, and I didn't want to let it go.
In 1979, Stacy Peralta would be the second Dogtown skater to win Skateboarder Magazine's Worldwide Readers Poll.
He stopped skating professionally, and then he hooked up with George Powell, and they started Powell Peralta, and he began the Bones Brigade, and he picked all the talent, and the few guys that he had picked on at the time were just revolutionary. Just this amazing group of skaters who were doing for skating what the Zephyr team did in the 70s, and he was the mastermind behind the whole thing.
In a relationship that would span three decades, Peralta would hook up with Craig Stessic as his creative partner and early mentor. Through a series of pioneering skateboard videos, Stessic and Peralta showcased the remarkable talents of the Bones Brigade to skaters the world over.
They turned that into the biggest skateboarding adventure ever.
I don't feel I came into my own until I was behind the scenes. That's when I flourished.